Module 15, Fresco Painting. Eminent, renowned Canadian writer and founder of creativity at work, Linda Nyman, has rightly said, "Art provides an opportunity for kaleidoscopic thinking. Each time we shift the lens of our perceptions, we gain perspectives and new opportunities for innovation." I placed the 12 inches by 12 inches square cement slab on a white drawing sheet and take a plaster bowl and put 3 portions of lime powder in it and add diluted Fevicol liquid in it and mix well with the help of a pointing trowel to make a paste and stir it well for some time till no lumps are found in the mixture. According to legendary Italian painter Leonardo da Vinci, painting is poetry that is seen rather than felt, and poetry is painting that is felt rather than seen. Now, after mixing well, a fine paste is achieved, and after that, with the help of a small pointing trowel, I start pouring the paste on the surface of this tile or slab, covering it properly, spreading the paste evenly to all sides. According to eminent American author Napoleon Hill, first comes thought, then organization of that thought into ideas and plans, then transformation of those plans into reality. The beginning, as you will observe, is in your imagination. Ken Robinson, an eminent British author and speaker, has rightly said, "Creativity is putting your imagination to work, and it's produced the most extraordinary results in human culture." All 4 sides of the slab are also coated with this mixture with the help of a pointing trowel. An eminent American realist painter and printmaker, Edward Hopper, has rightly said, "No amount of skillful imagination can replace the essential element of imagination." Excess material is removed from all sides. I used to pointing trowel to smoothen the top surface of the cement tile or slab. This process is repeated for a while so that the material is coated on the tile evenly. With the help of a wooden float or gurmala, I press the surface, move it from one side to the other in order to remove excess material and also to plane the surface. Sides are also given the same treatment with the wooden float or gurmala. Now I move the wooden float or gurmala in circular movements in order to spread the mixture evenly without any abrasions or depression. This whole exercise is done for getting a smooth plane surface for preparing it for the fresco painting. Sides are also smoothened and excess material is removed with the wooden float. Extra material on the drawing sheet and sides of the square tile is also removed. and if any depressions are found on the surface, a small amount of material is gently applied on the top surface. Now I lift the square tile on my left palm and apply a mixture of marble powder and water, which has a milk white shade on the already prepared surface with the help of a clean pointing trowel. The small amount of paste is to be applied and spread from one side to other. This way, I cover the whole tile slowly and slowly. I keep on spreading the marble powder mixture on the tile, shuffling the tile gently to cover the surface evenly. Then I remove the extra material by scraping the tile with the edge of pointing trowel. This process is repeated time and again till a smooth, plain, bright, white, shiny surface is achieved. Now it is the turn for the edges of this tile to be covered with the same material. A scraping exercise continues for a while on top of the tile surface with the pointing trowel. This helps in removing any coarseness on the surface of the tile. Care should be taken that no extra material or any rough edges are seen on the side. Then I clean the drawing sheet and place the tile on it, which is nearly half dry. In fresco painting style, an artist has to work on half wet surface quickly with diluted earth colors. I take a thin round brush and start drawing on the surface of the tile, creating small dots in blue earth color to make a dotted line. In the similar action, I draw the shape of an eyebrow and eye painting small dots. Now I extend the dotted line from top to bottom in a sort of diagonal shape. I draw another dotted line along the earlier line and then I make the eyeball. Now on the left side of the tile, I draw shapes of two leaves and stem in similar dotted lines. While drawing such shapes, less color should be applied, otherwise it will spread on the surface, distorting the shape. After that, I use thick round brush and add lots of spots in blue earth color in the form of texture on the face. Next, I use diluted yellow earth color and fill the remaining area near the cheek along the blue color, leaving some space in between them. Some more yellow earth color is added on the eyelid and the forehead. Now I darken the area around the leaves with diluted black earth color. Do not drag the brush while filling the earth colors. Use the filling technique with dots. Now I use diluted red earth color and fill the lower area of the tile around the leaves in thicker strokes or dots. The whole area of the cloth is covered with red earth color using gentle touches of the brush and randomly leaving some white areas. Dark green earth color is applied on the lower leaf in some dots technique. And a bit lighter tone of green earth color is applied on the upper leaf. According to renowned Polish sculptor and fiber artist Magdalena Abakanowicz, art will remain the most astonishing activity of mankind, born out of a struggle between wisdom and madness, between dream and reality in our mind. Sides are also covered with the earth colors used on the upper surface. All four sides should be covered with earth colors. Eye is completed by filling the portion of the eye with black earth color. The technique of filling the earth color should not be altered or changed. Eyebrow has been filled with black earth color. A few small dots are created on the white space of the eye to lessen the brightness. I keep the tile for drying and then start rubbing the top painted surface with the help of a smooth glass paper weight. The process is called burnishing, as it brings shine and fixes the earth color. This has to be done slowly, as sometimes some colored areas are still wet. The surface soaked some amount of colors and they seem a bit lighter in shade now. All area of tile should be rubbed smoothly so that we can get a smooth shiny surface. This process should go on for quite some time till you are satisfied that the color has been fixed and the surface becomes glossy.